Okay, how many of you have actually gone through the FFA consent form before addressing FFA for anybody? If you go through, I'm sure nobody will have an FFA done. Have any of us actually told the patient that you'll have itchy feeling all over the body? You'll feel breathless, you'll feel nauseous, we'll shift you if necessary. Have anybody told this? You have to tell the patient that the patient can sometimes collapse. It's going to help your kidneys function better with the dye going in the body. And there's a 1 in 2 lakh chance of death. Have anybody told, have any of you told your patients that? Honestly, there's always a first time for everything. Okay? So FFA is definitely not a very safe procedure to start with. The other simple fact is it always involves 20 to 25 minutes to do an FFA, whereas no CT hardly going to take 15 to 20 seconds. You don't need 9 needles, you don't need a Ventron, you can put up with a Ventron comprehensive patient, you don't need a physician unless they stand by. And more importantly, if you show the OCT printout, the patient is able to understand the pathology much, much better. What does the FFA do? It helps us to understand the so-called pathophysiology of diabetic retinal and RBU and AMD much better. But what the OCT does is, you know, let's get practical. It tells you when to treat, what to treat for, and probably is the best imaging modality. Accepted, the FFA does show some things that the OCT cannot show, like it can sometimes pick up an occult AMD for you, it can diagnose macular ischemia, and can diagnose peripheral CMP areas. But honestly, for everything else, the OCT is better. Okay, OCT today has made actually the general ophthalmologist committee the very definition of diabetic macular edema. Nobody talks about CSME. CSME is probably for your exams and it's out of the window more or less. We talk more of the studies are today or about whether the edema involves the center or not. It's about center involving or non-center involving. Okay? And the other thing OCT has done is given a total new classification about diabetic macular edema. You have 5 different types. You know, there used to be time when the macular edema never goes off. We used to keep hammering the retina with more and more laser, hoping the edema will come down. But today we have these 5 types of macular edema with which you have a fair idea. The first one is spongiform. The second is serous macular detachment, which I'm sure no OCT machine can show you what is a subretinal fluid. It shows you what amount of cystoid macular edema is there. It helps you to quantify even though the FFA shows up. Most importantly, it tells you when you need to go in and operate on a patient with diabetic macular edema. It shows you what is called as vitreomacular traction syndrome and tells you what is called as a taut posterior hyaloid. Another 2 pictures of taut posterior hyaloid. You know, this patient, you see, anybody would say this patient would need laser, but when you do the OCT, you see that there is a definite traction there and this patient actually needs surgery. Now, accepted, the FFA does show what is a cystoid macular edema. It's good for academics. You know, you can show the patholog leakage to your PGs and colleagues. But what is the use? You need an OCT to find out how much of edema is there. You need to know whether there's subretinal fluid. And more importantly, you need an OCT follow-up when you treat the patient like 2 weeks, 4 weeks, or 8 weeks when you're doing anti-VEGF. There are enough studies to show that today, between the correlation of FFA and OCT in the diagnosis of CME, the OCT, SD-OCT is as good as a FFA. And we have all the trials, be it whichever the RBO trials, the AMD trials, or the DRCR, do OCT as the imaging modality for follow-up. In AMD, we know nobody can ever dream about treating a wet AMD without an OCT. It is as good as in dry AMD as well. It compares very good with fundus fluorescence and autofluorescence. And there's something called enhanced depth imaging that has come up of late, wherein the choroid gets completely exposed. You know, anything beyond the RP, the FFA actually cannot see. So what is the use? Whereas the OCT nowadays can actually see up to this clear. The FFA only is going to show you the vascular filling part of retina, but OCT can show you the structural layers of the retina, the choroid, the RP, and grooves. In today's context, honestly, if you're a retina specialist, you know, who's just started specialty practice, what would one buy first? I know most of you think it's an FFA, but actually, if you see in a retina clinic, how many FFAs versus OCTs are done in a month or a year or a day? I'm sure most of retina surgeons will do more OCTs in a day than an FFA, which just shows that instead of paying the consultant and actually buying an OCT machine, it's the best consultant you can ever invest in. It makes you more money. Coming to the practical aspect of breaking even as well, the average cost of OCT is 2,500 for both eyes today, whereas FFA is around probably 1,500K. And I'm sure the number of OCTs done for diagnosis or follow-up are far more than FFA because thanks to the conditions we have, we literally have to do OCTs every month for at least 6 months. Now coming to the printout as such, you know, you don't actually need to see the fundus at all. You see the diabetic macular edema printout, it actually shows you what is the thickness. It shows you the hot area, shows you where the thickness is, how much of thickness is there. The lower OCT picture shows you how much of CME is there. Okay, coming to the final couple of slides. Okay, FFA is a good machine. It's nice, just one moment, last 2 slides. It's nice to have in a clinic, use it once in a while. But we're drinking indications. But FFA is something that technology has come in the last 10 years. It's made dental practice easy for general ophthalmologists, and it's what the future is all about. I don't deny the fact that FFA is a damn good investigation for retinal detachment, but we need to understand that in today's context, the OCT is a far better machine. Thank you.